Hi everyone and welcome back. The last time I went outside with the Dwarf II Smart Telescope to capture the moon, I had a big surprise. First, the live stacking was faster, it stacked more images in the same amount of time, and at the end, when I stopped the live stacking, I finally saw an amazing image with the moon without having to make post-processing. The moon just looked amazing. And this is an example from 2023 when you can see the moon didn't have a good color balance when watching the results directly from the live stack. It was more reddish. When I made the video comparison between the Dwarf 2 and the Seestar S50 last year, I also suggested to improve the white balance on the final results from the stack because we want a great result directly from the app. So we want to capture the moon, live stacking, and get a good white balance image that looks like the moon in the sky. It's not other color. And finally they did it. And now not only the Seestar S50 has a good white balance, but also the Dwarf 2. And having this great result, it was very easy if I wanted to make some adjustments. After, I just went, sharpened the image a little bit and increased the brightness. That's all. It took me like 1 or 2 minutes. And this is a huge improvement. And I'm really happy that dwarflab listened to me and also watched the video comparison that I made with the Seestar and the Dwarf 2. And now we do have much better results when capturing the moon using the Dwarf 2. And now we can enjoy beautiful images with the moon. It also stacks faster, so you can leave it more. On this test, I left the Dwarf 2 imaging the moon for about 5 minutes. And let's zoom in a little bit and see some details. Here we have Copernicus crater, near Terminator on the shadow. We can see also Eratosthenes. We can see Plato crater. If we go lower, we can see one of my favorite craters, Clavius crater, and one of the largest craters on the moon. You can see how good quality we have here. For the Dwarf 2, this is a big step up. We have good white balance finally. With the white balance corrected, we can get a beautiful image directly from the app, and you don't really need to do a lot of extra processing. You can do some adjustments if you want to, but it will look great directly from the dwarflab app. Well, I hope you enjoyed watching, and I wish you all to have a nice time with the Dwarf 2 outside at night, and of course, clear sky.